Apart from the scandal, there is a very real legal element to the Harvey Weinstein saga. According to at least one news source, the FBI is reportedly investigating him right now, as is the New York City Police Department. We're joined now by Judge Jeanine Pirro, who hosts Justice with Judge Jeanine Saturday nights at 9 right here on Fox. Before she was a judge, she was a very well-known prosecutor specializing in sex crimes, so she seemed the perfect person. Judge, where does Harvey Weinstein stand legally right now?
In a lot of trouble, Tucker. Look, I heard the tape that NYPD, the Special Victims Unit, put together. Make no mistake, that tape would have been sufficient in my office when I was the DA to prosecute Harvey Weinstein. And the excuse that the tape was insufficient to prove a crime is simple hogwash. The tape that there was no intent shown, or the argument that there's no intent shown on the tape, is the same argument that Jim Comey used with Hillary. The intent is a secret silent operation of your mind. And in right. this particular tape, the intent is shown by Harvey Weinstein's own words. He says, oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I won't do it again. She specifically says on the tape, but you touched my breast. And he says, oh, I'm sorry. I won't do it then. Just come in and just watch me shower. This is a perfect case. She was wired. She went to the police immediately. They see her on surveillance cameras running out, very upset, acting just like a young woman who had been groped would act. This is a predator. He is a serial predator. He has preyed on vulnerable young women. And he dangles a carrot of fame and fortune and the ability to be in movies. And he's gotten right. away with it. And there is a question as to whether or not Cyrus Vance, the DA who rejected this tape by NYPD, has taken money from Harvey Weinstein. And I'm not suggesting that they're necessarily connected. But here's the bottom line. Any DA worth his or her salt would have gone forward with a jury, because this isn't just a he said, she said. This is a she said, he said, and then he said exactly what she said on the tape.
We know that Cyrus Vance, the prosecutor you referred to, did take apparently $10,000 from David Boies, who is kind of in-house Democratic Party lawyer, worked for the Clintons, and worked for Harvey Weinstein, was representing Weinstein in this matter. Would that be improper for a prosecutor to take money from a lawyer whose case he'd just dropped? I don't understand how that's allowed.
You know, unless you can show a nexus, Tucker, I mean, there are lawyers. Look, David Boies is a lawyer who represents all kinds of people.
Yeah, he does.
And that would be very hard to show necessarily a nexus between that case and that contribution and Harvey Weinstein. But you don't even need to go that far, Tucker. You've got a case here, and any prosecutor worth his or her salt would have gone forward with that case.
So why
and to
didn't he?
Say that the NYPD didn't do their job. This is a stellar job wiring up a victim who, by all accounts, was impeccable in catching him in this case.
It sure seems like it was not their fault. I mean, I don't know how much tighter they could have made the case. So that gets back to the central question, and you never want to think prosecutors are corrupt, because that's the deepest kind of corruption. But why wouldn't Cy Vance have gone forward with this?
Look, I can't get into Cy Vance's mind. I don't know what he was thinking, but it's just as people say. When you've got a case with a high-profile defendant, the prosecutors very often say to themselves, is this going to be worth it? Is she credible? You know, this guy's going to bring right. in all the big guns. He's going to bring in all the money. But the truth is on the tape, Tucker. There is nothing to argue here. Turn on the tape, let the jury listen to right. it, and send them into the deliberation room to deliberate.
You think of all the cases that don't have that go forward. Really quickly, where does Harvey Weinstein stand now? The Daily Mail is reporting the feds are looking into him, NYPD. Do you think he's in legal jeopardy now?
Do I think? I know he's in legal jeopardy right now. This guy is a serial predator. He is a recidivist. Based upon the simple stuff that we've been reading in the media, he has been doing it over and over. He's admitted he's been doing it over and over. And the claim that, gee, I'm sorry, I'm going to get help. Nobody cares, Harvey, if you get help. We are not social right. service workers. We're in law enforcement. We're DAs. We're in the criminal justice system. It's time for you to fess up, although he already has fessed messed up in many different ways. It's time for justice, period.
I don't know how going to a $1,000 a night facility to talk about yourself with a therapist is exculpatory in any way, but they keep pointing to it. Judge Jeanine, former prosecutor Jeanine Pirro, thanks for joining us tonight. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Tucker.